When I'm asked to give a speech to a class, students like this, and I know that very many of you are mature, okay? I always like to tell the truth, okay? Tell it as it was, okay? And hope you will realize what it was like for some of us when we were your age, but we were far from that. Now, on behalf of Branch Number 43, the Royal Canadian Legion, I'd like to thank you for us taking part in your ceremony today. Now, while we were overseas, most of our casualties would occur just when we had gone in theater or when we were coming out of theater. Naturally, going in, we were inexperienced. While we had been in for a while and our rotation dates were nearing, our thoughts were about going home. And I also like to point out to you that a great many of us in the modern military volunteered for more than one tour of duty overseas. And I also feel that it's important that when you have a message on Remembrance Day, that it comes from a veteran. Okay? Now, the title of my speech today is Prayer. It's a small word, prayer. Now, just for a moment, I want you to close your eyes and think. When was the last time you prayed? When you prayed, what did you pray for? And why did you pray? Here is my reflections. Prayer. As a youth growing up, my role models were my parents, my relatives, plus my school teachers, and it's safe to say that these people were the ones who set the standard for the rest of my life. On completion of school, I joined the military. And with the distractions of a military career in the Army, attending church was a low priority on my things to do. We were required to attend Padre's Hour in recruit training. Then one day our unit was tasked to a war zone. There was a United Nations mandate to uphold. With our wills prepared, a leave pass in our hand, we were sent home to say goodbye to our loved ones. And then we were off on an adventure, just like our forefathers. Once in theater, we witnessed the devil's handiwork and man's inhumanity to man, with death and destruction of people and their lives. We saw homeless people before that was even a word in our vocabulary. The refugees, the helpless orphans, the innocent men, women, and children being victimized by armed thugs and corrupt governments. The unarmed civilians suffered the worst and looked to us for protection. All the while, we were reminded of our families back home.
While this was happening, we had to patrol day and night to enforce the UN mandate. We used force when necessary. You had to be cool, stay alive, watch out for each other, and contend with being shot at. Booby traps, poisonous snakes, insects.
If you were a section commander or a platoon commander, you were held responsible for the actions of your men. As a teenager, thousands of miles from home, how do you keep all this together? Your training doesn't always cover some of the events you may experience. 50 years ago, there was no counseling for what we encountered.
When it was your turn to get some sleep, how do you put all that you have witnessed aside so that you can get some rest? It was difficult at first, but I soon learned that if I laid on my back, closed my eyes, said my prayers that I learned in Sunday school, sang my favorite hymn to myself, rest and sleep would overcome me. This is how, as a youth, I returned to my religious upbringing.
After our tour of duty, we returned home. Me, I had gray hair due to stress and fear. I never talked about my experiences. Who would believe you? Canadians live in a peaceful nation. Then, a few years later, while I was sharing a beer and some stories with some World War I or World War II vets in the local Legion, I related what I had seen, heard, and smelled, and how it affected me, and what I had to do to come to terms with it, and how I used to get some rest. They reassured me that they knew lots of fellas, and themselves included, who did a lot of praying during their war experiences and were not ashamed to admit it to anyone.
Yeah.